as compared to 2016 election, and that caused billions of disenfranchisement sa aming constituencies. Tama yung sinasabi ng Mr. Chair. Ako Bicol party is in 2016 garnered almost 1.7 million votes. 1.1 million of which belongs to the Bicol region. Ngayon, kalahati lang ako galing sa Bicol region. Bumagsak po kami ng 600,000 votes. The reason being that pag tinanong mo yung mga Bicolan, hindi namin alam kung saan nakalagay yung party list. Nandun sa likod. Even my law partner, used to be my law partner in my law office, tumawag sa amin, kung nakalimutan ko, bumalik ako sa polling place para sumigaw lang yung party list nasa likod. Walang nag-a-advise sa mga butante na yung party list nasa likod. And that's why the numbers only tells of 40%, not less than even 50% turnout, total votes cast in the party list election. Bakit nyo ho nilagay sa likod?
Mr. Chair, Mr. Deputy Chair, first of all, the Chair mentioned specifically that in the past, matataas ang numbers na nakukuha ng party list elections. I would like to point out that since 2010, 2013, 2016, all the party list elections have always been at the back of the ballot. It's always been there. Mahirap po ipagkasya sa harapan.
Mr. Chairman,
Yes, sir.
Buboto ko yung pre-election. This is the first time
sa harapan nilagay sa ikot ng party list.
Sige po.
Magkasunod po yan. After Senator, being national, sunod elect party list ka agad. This is the first time.
Sige po. My memory of it is different and I apologize if I'm wrong, but we will check that po. The second point that I'd like to make is that the party list elections, the elections on the ground are managed by boards of election inspectors. These are teachers that underwent training from the COMELEC. Sa training po ng COMELEC, kami ay nagbibigay ng information sa kanila na ang balota ay two-sided. Which means that we expected that the teachers themselves would be able to give this instruction. We will have to find out from the teachers themselves kung na-miss nila yung point na yan or kung hindi yan nabanggit sa mga botante. And third, again, we have to look at how the voter education is probably designed. The problem is that if you're looking for the party list elections, it's sort of surprising that you would not look at both sides of the ballot, that you would assume na walang party list component yung balota. But we will look into that very specifically and work that into the voter education. And again, I will very, very gladly check the old ballots that we have on record. And kung ganun nga po, and certainly that might be something that we will want to go back to kung talagang practice na namin.